I am Dr. Sinta Somesh Sarrao, working as assistant professor in Department of Computer Science and Engineering. Now I am going to explain some basics which are used in distance-based models. What are the distance-based models? The models which are used distance measures is called a distance-based models. Some of the distances used are Euclidean distance, Manhattan distance, Minkowski distance or Pavlovsky distance, and among many others which are used to recognize similarities between contents, and exemplars which are centroids that find a center of mass according to a chosen distance metric, or medoids that find the most centrally located data point, and Bayesian-based Bayesian rules which take a vote among k nearest exemplars. Here I am going to explain some of the distance measures. One of the distance measures is Minkowski distance of order p greater than 0 is defined as this p of x comma y is equal to sigma j is equal to 1 to t mod xj minus yj power p whole power 1 by p is equal to norm x minus y p, where x minus y represented with a z, that is norm z at p is equal to sigma j is equal to 1 to t norm zj power p whole power 1 by p is the p norm of the vector z. We will often refer to this p simply as the p norm. Instead of p, we'll write the or consider 2, that will be called as the 2 norm, refers to the familiar Euclidean distance. Here Euclidean distance is a measure which is used to measure the distance between contents. This of x comma y get 2 is equal to root over sigma j is equal to 1 to d xj minus yj whole square. It is also represented with x minus y transpose into x minus y. Manhattan distance is also called a city block distance. Instead of p, we will write 1. That is, this of x comma y 1 is equal to sigma j is equal to 1 to d modulus of xj minus yj. By using this formula, we are going to measure the distance between two points x and xj and yj. This is the distance if we can only travel along coordinate axis. If we now let p go larger, the distance will be more and more dominated by the largest coordinate wise distance, from which we can infer that distance of x comma y at infinity is equal to max j xj minus yj. This is also called a Chebyshev distance. Some of the discussions, we will sometimes refers to the O norm, which counts the number of non-zero elements in a vector. It is called a L0 norm. The corresponding distance then counts the number of positions in which vectors x and y differ. This is not strictly Minkowski distance. However, we can define it as distance of x comma y at 0 is equal to sigma j is equal to 1 to d xj minus yj whole power 0 is equal to sigma j is equal to 1 to d I into xj is equal to yj, under the understanding that x power 0 is equal to 0 for x equal to 0 and 1 otherwise. If x and y are binary string, this is called the Hamming distance. In this formula, x and y are the binary string. This is called the Hamming distance. Alternatively, we can see the Hamming distance as the number of bits that need to be flipped to change x into y. For non-binary strings of unequal length, this can be generalized to the notion of edit distance or Lewisian distance. If the x and y are the binary string, then we will call it as a Hamming distance. If that x and y are non-binary strings, we will call it as edit distance. Some of the metrics of the distance measures. Given an instance space x, a distance metric is a function dist x by x gives r such that for any x comma y comma z belongs to x. Distance between a point and itself will always measure as 0. That is, dist of x comma x is equal to 0. All other distances are larger than 0. If x naught is equal to y, then distance of x comma y greater than 0. Distances are symmetric if distance of y comma x is equal to distance of x comma y. That means distance of y comma x is equal to distance of x comma y. Detours cannot shorten the distance. That means distance of x comma z less than or equal to distance of x comma y plus distance of y comma z. If the second condition is weakened, this is the second condition, may be weakened to a non-strict inequality, that is, distance of x comma y may be 0 even if x not is equal to y. The function d is called a pseudometric. If distance between a point and itself are 0, that means distance of x comma x is equal to 0. Even if x not is equal to y, in that case also, maybe we will get the 0. Why the function d is called a pseudometric. Mahalanobis distance. This is the inverse of the covariance matrix. M is equal to sigma inverse. This leads to the definition of the Mahalanobis distance. Distance of x comma y is equal to x minus y transpose into sigma inverse into x minus y. Using the covariance matrix in this way has the effect of decorrelating and normalizing the feature. Clearly, Euclidean distance is a special case of Mahalanobis distance with identity matrix I as the covariance matrix. That is, distance of x comma y is equal to distance m x comma y at I. Means and distances. The arithmetic mean minimizes squared Euclidean distance. That means arithmetic mean mu of a set of data points t in a Euclidean space is unique point that minimizes the sum of squares Euclidean distance to those data points. That means the arithmetic mean of mu of a set of data points t in Euclidean space is unique point that minimizes the sum of squares Euclidean distance to those data points. That is, we will show that argument y sigma x belongs to D nor x minus y whole square is equal to mu, where this double straight line denotes the true norm. We find this minimum by taking the gradient of the sum and setting it to the zero vector. What happens if we drop the square here? In this previous equation, what happens? We drop the square. Would not it be more natural to take the point that minimizes total Euclidean distance? As example, this point is known as symmetric mean. As per univariate data, it corresponds to the median or middle value of a set of numbers. In the previous equation, we will drop the square. At this point, we will call it as a geometric mean. As for the univariate data, it corresponds to the median or middle value of a set of numbers. However, for multivariate data, there is no closed form expression for geometric mean. In certain situations, it makes sense to restrict an exemplar to be one of the given data points. In that case, we speak of a method medoid to distinguish it from a centroid, which is an exemplar that does not have to occur in the data. Finding a medoid requires us to calculate for each data point the total distance to all other data points in order to choose point that minimizes it. Centroids and medoids, which are shown in this figure, is a small set of 10 points. Here will represent all the data points the data points are represented with the plus. This square two norm centroid, square two norm medoid, This circles indicates centroids and squares indicating medoids for different distance metrics. Notice how the outlier on the bottom right pulls the mean away from geometric median. As a result, the corresponding medoid changes as well. In this diagram, we show the data points, squared, medoids, distance matrix, and outlier. The basic linear classifier constructs the decision boundary as the perpendicular bisector of the line segment connecting the two exemplars. An alternative distance base way to classify instances without direct reference to a decision boundary. If x is the nearest to mu, then classify it as a positive, otherwise as negative. In the nearest basic linear classifier, if we consider one point in a, two points in a space, we'll measure the distance. The smaller distance of points will be considered as single class. If x is nearest to mu, then classify it as positive, otherwise as negative. We use Euclidean distance as our closeness measure. Simple geometry tells us we get exactly same relation boundary. That same relation boundary shown in this left side figure. So the basic linear classifier can be interpreted from a distance space perspective as constructing exemplars that minimize squared Euclidean distance within each class and then applying a nearest example decision rule. In the left side figure, for two exemplars, the nearest example decision rule with Euclidean distance results in a linear decision boundary coinciding with perpendicular bisector of the line connecting the two exemplars. Here, instead of circles, we represent with the squares and connecting with the Manhattan distance, where circles are replaced by the diamonds. Here, left side figure, Portnoy tessellation of 5 exemplars, middle, taking the two nearest exemplars, right, the shading indicates which exemplars contribute which cell. This left side figure gives a Voronoi tessellation for 5 exemplars. Each line segment is part of the perpendicular bisector of 2 exemplars. There are 10 pairs of exemplars, but 2 of these pairs are too far away from each other. So, we observe only 8 line segment in the Voronoi tessellation. By observing this, only 8 line segments in Voronoi tessellation. 10 pairs of examples, but 2 of those pairs are too far away from each other. Middle figure, if we now also take second nearest examplers into account, each Voronoi cell is the further subdivided for this figure, subdivided into central point has 4 neighbors. The central cell is divided into 4 subregions. These are the 1, 2, 3, 4 subregions. We can think of those additional line segments as being part of Voronoi tessellation that results when the central point is removed. The other exemplars have only 3 immediate neighbors and so their cells are divided into 3 subregions. By observing this right side figure, we thus obtain 16 2 nearest exemplars decision regions, each of which is defined by a different pair of nearest and second nearest exemplars. Figure, this particular right shades of these regions according to the two nearest exemplars spanning it. In this lecture, I am explained about some basics which are needed for distance-based models and that model, that distance matrix are Euclidean distance, Manhattan distance, Minkowski distance, and their formula, and nearest neighbors, and then their importance. This distance measures will measure the distance between contents. Thank you.